Okay, welcome back, Peter. Union Square, Monday. Monday, October the 2nd.
Yes.
Beautiful day in the neighborhood. And we averted two frosts in a row. And the forecast for the next 10 days looks pretty darn good. In the short run, I'm a happy farmer. In the long run, what does this do to the ecology? Not exactly sure, but I'm sure it's not that good. But at least for now, we're gonna have we'll have our tomatoes and our eggplants and our peppers, albeit slower than when it's warm and hot like the last week. But we will still have them. They did not die. So we were supposed to get 30 degrees on what was it? Two nights ago, it only went down to 34. So that slows things down, but it doesn't kill them. Other than things like basil. Basil don't like it. Nothing really new. Oh, there is one new thing that's hopefully coming down the pike in 1 to 2 weeks, which is our sweet potatoes. So we're only growing two types of sweet potatoes this year. One is the purple one from Japan. It's Japanese purple.
Oh, I like those.
Those are very grainy and not very sweet, so they're really good for folks with diabetes. You can eat those. In fact, they have an insulin mimicking chemical in them. And then the other varieties are actually a ton of varieties that we're experimenting with our good friend John Hart. And so those are going to be various different colors, and we're trying to breed sweet potatoes that'll tolerate the Northeast. So he's actually coming in from Florida on Sunday the 8th to observe and partake in the harvest to see how they did. This is not a good sweet potato year for sure, because it wasn't warm enough. But that's the whole idea, to see how they do in adversity. And the only other newish thing that we'll have is, when I start harvesting it, is turmeric. So that I'm waiting as long as I can, because it takes forever for those things to yield. So enjoy the summer crops while we still have them. And at least for now, we have a reprieve of about 10 days, I hope.
So, the ecology that you're talking about, like the fact that is it that you're overworking the land? Or is
it... Not that per se, more the how does the ecology basically deal with the warming temperatures? Okay, so we get milder winters and we get longer summers. You know, our normal average frost has been mid to the third week of September, and we haven't had an average frost in years, basically. So, you know, in general, things are getting slightly warmer, so that's going to mess with all beings. You know, things can move further north that haven't lived in our area, and things that are used to the cold are used to the temperatures that we used to have may not like the new situation. And so, you know, in the end, there's always an equilibrium, but maybe mayhem before we reach that. But at least, like I said, for the short run, makes me happy because I get a few more weeks out of my crops and they won't die.
Makes me happy because I'm eating good food.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay.
So That's what's happening at Norwich Meadows Farm.
Thank you.
Thank you.
See you at the market.
See you at the market.
Haifa and Zaid are two of the nicest people I've met in the market. That's saying a lot, because I've been coming to the market for over 35 years now. I'm happy to know them. I mean, you know, what else could I say? You know?
Thank you.
I am, and I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Because I'm a cynical son of a gun at times. So when you meet people who are in the industry and they have a dedication to quality goods, which is the basis of our existence, food and shelter, I mean, what more can I say that, you know, it makes me feel like there's hope. And I hope that this gets they can one day reach into the hearts of the residents of the lower Manhattan area who don't even have a consciousness except for little crappy restaurants that serve them God knows what.
$10. 12 minutes.